this set up. Give everyone a moment to get in here. Hello, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. Oh, let's get my water bottle out of the way. Soda out of the way. Welcome to Dark Cloud 2. This is, oh gosh. This is, oh, we're going to cutscene here. This is something different that I wanted to try. You won't even be able to hear me. This is something different I want to try. I've been playing Dark Cloud 2. I mean, I first played Dark Cloud 2 when it originally released in 2003. And it's probably my favorite game on the PlayStation 2. So I've been playing this game a lot, just kind of, you know, in between playing a lot of new releases and other such games. But I really keep coming back to this and figured we'd play it on stream. So for those of you who are watching live on Twitch, thank you so much. We're just going to be kind of hanging out. But for the rest of you, those who are here on YouTube right now, welcome. This is a new kind of Let's Play. It's not the Impact Factor Plays, which is more focused around kind of showing you a continuous experience, either from the beginning of a game or, you know, a snippet of kind of an activity you do often, whereas this free play is pretty much just you hop in and out of my experience. This is games that I play off stream, make progress in, so it's not necessarily a continuous experience, and so it's really just me hanging out, grinding, doing the necessary thing, moving through the game, having fun while doing so. Probably best experienced watching live on Twitch. And that's, again, twitch.tv/megalodonphd. Watch live, chat with me, have some fun. We're going to be playing some Dark Cloud 2 today. Again, my favorite, I don't know, it's hard to say, but I think my favorite game from the PlayStation 2 era. And, a game that really stuck with me for a long time. When I saw that it was releasing in on the PlayStation 4 as part of this PlayStation 2 upgrade program, where they kind of they up-res the visuals a little bit, but they only do so much. It's not a complete remake. They have trophy support, you know, they just make the experience work on PS4, which is nice. You had to rebuy it, but whatever. I don't have my PlayStation 2 with me. It's still at home. So right now we're at Mount Gundor, and if the chat is interested, well, I'll do a brief intro. Dark Cloud 2, you play as a pair of heroes, Max, a young boy, and Monica. Yeah, we're at Mount Gundor already. Monica, who is this princess from the future. The overarching plot is that there's an evil emperor from 10,000 years in the past named Emperor Griffin, who is imposing his evil will throughout time. To kind of, I don't know, end the world. He wants to collect all these rare stones called the Atlamalia. He has the yellow Atlamalia, Max is the red, and Monica's the blue. Atlamalia are magic stones that choose their owner and have special powers. For instance, Max allows him to go into the future, and Monica allows hers to go into the past. Currently, one of Emperor Griffin's evil plans is by destroying this current timeline that we're living in, thereby preventing a future where forces can oppose him. So the game kind of moves in between the past and the present and the future, and a lot of what you're doing in the present is going to the destroyed future, the alternate timeline future, seeing how you can improve it, and then going and trying to fix it in your current time by building with basically a Sims-like game where you build cities that fulfill certain requirements. That's a pretty basic description, but again, this is a free play. Those of you watching on YouTube, this is a free play. Obviously, we're jumping right into the middle of the experience. This is chapter 4 of, I think, 7, so I'm like halfway through the game already. It's a game that I'll be playing off-stream as well. And really, it's just about hanging out, having a good time. Speaking of hanging out and having a good time, what is up, Elrota, Rad Trooper, and Tetris for me? All hanging out in the chat. Oh, bug. So Dark Cloud is a kind of half and half. It's an RPG with whose main kind of gameplay mechanic is dungeon crawling. But then again, there's a lot of other mechanics that go in there, like the city building that was first introduced in the original Dark Cloud. Oh yeah, so I'm preempting YouTube people who may watch later. Now clearly, not a lot of people ever watch my videos, but oh gosh. But you know, maybe some people will watch him at some point in the future. I got gooed here. It's a status effect. Oh, gosh. Yeah, probably the latter. I could stream to YouTube, but seriously, nobody watches YouTube streams. Oh, gosh. Nobody watches YouTube streams for live games. And let's heal myself. So there's a lot to jump into, so chat, if you have any questions, let me know. Let me know what's happening, and I'll explain as need be. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. I hate these things. Yeah, Twitch, yeah, not dipping in that Twitch and YouTube gaming. What is up? What is up? Yes, this is a very nostalgic game. Brings me back to when I first played it 13 years ago. Yeah, a long time ago. Baby Mega. How is everyone's days going so far? I had a pretty good day. Had to make a lab meeting for tomorrow, but I got that done because I wanted to stream for you guys. I don't want to do no work at night. I want to play some video games, hang out with my friends. Let's switch over to Monica for a little bit. So the point of each dungeon, you can do a couple things. The dungeon is filled with monsters. One monster will have a special key which can be used to open the exit to the dungeon and move on to the next level. There are items to collect, treasure chests to open. And you get bonuses for clearing stuff, and then once you've cleared a floor, extra challenges arise. Like, there's this golf minigame called Sveta, that I will be playing and sucking at, most likely. As well as, you know, depending on the different dungeon floor, there's different, you can fish on it, or everything. Those little blue orbs are experience points. The coins, oh gosh, are, so this is my ride pod. Each character also has a secondary form they can take. Max's, who's I'm playing right now, is an inventor, and he makes this giant flying death robot. And you can power up the robot, you can craft different parts to make it more powerful, yada yada yada. Oh, I'll play with my mini-map small, so it's not completely covering the screen. I've gotten used to it, but I know it could be distracting for some people. But Elroda, Rad Trooper, Tetris with me, how was your day? Oh, I'm just glad to be streaming. You're not into RPGs? Not into the 13-year-old RPGs era, Mr. Rad Trooper? I figured I'd spare you guys Crypt of the Necrodancer today, because I've beaten Zone 3, I'm on the final zone, Zone 4, and I've gotten to the final boss, or happens to be two bosses to the final zone, but then died, and it's just demoralizing. I'm zapped. Gosh. Well. Anyway, watching me is exhausting. Oh. So each weapon levels up independently. There's a whole system in this game of leveling up your weapons. You can break down items, and they give you different stat points. And every time your weapon levels up, you get more of these synthesis points down on the bottom left here. And you use those to build up your weapons. You kind of evolve your weapons like you would evolve Pokemons. Why is everyone rioting? Nobody rioting in the chat. And so right now, I'm just trying to build up my weapons. Let's get some exorcism, though. So I'm pretty far in the game. Yeah, Tetris, I've been playing this game a lot. Like, every time I get a chance, I'm like, I can play some Dark Cloud. So yeah, that's why I'm running up Mount Gundor. Cyclone, Exorcism, or Lightning and Exorcism. So let's do Lightning. So what you're telling me, Mad Troopers, you don't like games where you micromanage stats? I think you would love something like this, man. It's a management sim. You're just managing different resources. Yeah, the weapon system's awesome. It feels so satisfying, like, when you level up a weapon and you, you get to the point where you're like, oh my god, I'm getting so close to the ultimate weapon. Alright, which way do I wanna go? Okay. Tetris, I'm curious, how do you play with your minimap? Do you play no minimap, side quarter minimap, or full screen minimap? Because I always just play full screen minimap, but, I'm gonna keep it in the corner for the stream so you guys can actually see the beautiful PS2 graphics upscaled for the PlayStation 4, the most powerful console on the market. If you don't count Steam consoles. Though I don't know, it might be more powerful than Steam consoles. Probably not. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. Really, it doesn't appeal. Okay, okay. Get killed! Are full or none, yeah. So yeah, Tetris says he uses full or none. That's true. This quarter minimap is like helpful, but then not like a lot. But... Hi-ya! The only thing that's annoying, playing through this again, Tetris and everyone in the chat, is those little blue orbs are experience, but if you don't collect them, if they don't zoom into you, you literally don't get the experience for killing the monster. Like, it's such a bizarre choice. It's like, why would they do that? Like, you could kill a monster, and then sometimes you have, like, this geography here, like, you see these little steam vents happening on the side. If those blue orbs fall down there, sometimes they could just be lost forever, and you can lose experience points. It's like, great, thanks. Thanks, game. And then you also always have to wait around, over the body of a monster to collect its guts. I actually, Elrota, funny you should mention that, I have purchased and installed Firewatch. I have the custom Firewatch theme on my PlayStation 4 too, because the art from Ali Moss is so good. But I will not be streaming that, or at least my first playthrough will not be streamed. I'm gonna be, Justine and I already said we're gonna play that together. On our own, so. Maybe tomorrow I'll stream our second playthrough of it. Well. So this is the other character, this is Monica. Uh-oh, no. And she can transform into a monster. But it's useless. Her monster transformation is seriously useless. Nope. Hey man, I think her normal outfit is so boring, so I'll give her the Star Leotard. At least I don't have her in like the animal skin underwear. You better put a cap on that. There's something so satisfying about, clearing dungeons. Get killed! Ah! Oh yeah, I think that's the final monster.
Looks like we got them all.
Couple stream. Well, I'll run it by her, Elrodah. I'll run it by her if she wants to do a couple streams. She probably won't, but we'll see. If she agrees, then we'll stream Firewatch. It looks really good, though. Very excited for it. If nothing else, the pedigree behind that game has me really excited, because it's a bunch of really smart former games journalists who make one of, like, gosh, dang it. One of the most thoughtful games podcasts with Idle Thumbs. And then it has a bunch of talent, former Telltale games, you know, the people who made Walking Dead Season 1, which is incredible. So hey, Tetris, you're telling me you haven't bought Dark Cloud 2 already? What do you do, man? You get to watch me fail at Sveta. Alright, so this is a little golf mini game that happens sometimes when you clear a dungeon. Well, except, as you might have guessed, the ball can fall into the geography. Alright. We're going here. I'd also say the systems are pretty deep. It has a lot of replayability. Let's just do this. Let's just do a little short hop. A little bit of backspin. And there's also so much to do. This is like a very... Okay, this is a very grindy JRPG, but the grinding is rewarded. The fun factor. Oh gosh, let's put a meaty backspin on it. Yeah! Uh-oh. Don't do this to me. Alright. Alright, camera didn't completely screw me over here. So you have to match up the color of the ball so it's the opposite of the distortion. Red Trooper, you're not one to talk about boring games. I'm sure, like, 90% of the games you play would be so boring to watch. All these different management simulators. Topaz. Thanks, Tetris. Yeah, man, I thought I'd totally F up my spade on stream, but nope. Cleared that distortion pretty handily. It's really hard, because, like, your ball can fall out in these holes here, which is totally innate. It's like, it makes no sense. It's so frustrating. Oh, okay. Sorry, there's a lot of chat going on. I thought you said Dark Clouds, but I'm like, whoa. Maybe it's boring, but it has the same JRPG boringness. Like, if this game is boring, all JRPGs are boring. Because it has the same kind of grindiness. Well, I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say all JRPGs. That's being a little bit hyperbolic. It's a little bit more grind-heavy than other JRPGs. Like, grind built into the systems. But I'm enjoying it. I enjoy this game. Here's the exit key that I got from a fallen monster. And I can move to the next floor. Jerk. Let's save. Do I neurotic JRPG saving? What do we got here? Desperation on the mountain. Alright. Defeat the monsters using just monster transformation. Yeah, that's not happening. You do. Hey, I mean. I was just playing with you, but I would love to see you stream your gameplay on some of these management sims. I want to see, You should set up Red Trooper. You should stream some Kerbal Space Program. I know it's not really a management sim, but I'd love to see you play KSP. I'm not messing around, man. Yeah, I gotta. Aw, man. This weapon can't be built up yet because I have to kill a certain monster, but I already have all its stats high enough, which is just frustrating. Oh, cubic hammer. Nah, I'm not messing around, man. 27 hours? Puh. Child's play. When did this game come out? Last week? No, it came out two weeks ago. Oh, I got a picture. I gotta get a picture of this Bomberman. There's a whole picture system too for inventions. You need to take pictures to get ideas and combine ideas to invent stuff. Oh my gosh, there's so much in this game. Oh, oops, I'm past it. I I want to see. I want to see you spending an hour to explain game physics. Come on, blow up, man. So certain photos you can only get by doing, like, taking a photo of a monster's attack. And they only do it so often. Come on, do the head blowy uppy thingy. So this thing does a move where it'll like make its head bigger and blow itself up. But I gotta take a picture of it. Come on, man. Good shot. Gosh dang it. Come on. Dang it. This freaking thing. Oh. Aw, man, I missed it. That's what happens. You're supposed to take a picture of that, but I missed it. Yeah. We'll get the next one. I think there's 6 of them on this floor. Especially because I'm replaying this game, I've been having like guides up just so I can get the 100% best build. All right, let's go check Veronica. How was everyone's work today? Tetris, did you work at all today? Or you're just a lazy college kid, just going to class, not giving a hoot. Man, I killed him too fast. So that's another kind of a little tedious thing in this game is, again, I think I said it earlier, but you only get experience points for the weapon that gets the killing blow. So to level up your little armband, which is your magic weapon here, you have to get the killing blow with that. All right, Tetris working twice tomorrow, okay. Up, I'm ready. No, stay away from me, dragon. Come on. Good shot. Aw, man, I totally didn't even snap it. Gosh dang it. It's so hard to get. Some of these monster scoops is what they're called. Really hard to get. Get killed. Oh, gosh dang it. See, like, they do that so fast. Ugh, gosh, man, come on. Freaking punks. Oh, man, come on. So annoying. Oh, well, Rhoda, you have a thing against a cool space program? Well, not getting that scoop. Oh, Max. Max got wrecked by an exploding bomb because I couldn't get the scoop. What are your favorite kinds of games to watch, Elroda? Is it just narrative-based games? I need to be careful now, because if Monica dies, I get a game over. And I get sent back to the main menu. I have to replay this floor of the dungeon. Death to all Kerbals. Ooh, Elroda's calling it out. I wonder if it's a game you enjoy playing, Elroda. Yay, Angel Coin. Experience bonus. It's coming out on PlayStation 4. Would you recommend for someone like me, Rad Trooper, to play it? Oh, okay, we got more bomb heads. But Max is dead. Gosh, dang it. Oh. Probably Zions! That PS2 camera craziness. Alright, get killed, Bomberhead. No, I wanted to finish him off with my armlet. Rat Trooper says, been flirting with playing Crusader Kings 2 and then rolling that save on Europa Universalis 4. I'm not streaming either of that, though. Well, whatever you streamed, I would watch there, Rat Trooper, because I'm sure it would be super interesting, because it's not games at all I would find myself playing. Oops. No, gosh dang it. I thought I could get away with one more hit before it died. Nope. Certain situations for having a mouth. You would think, though, that they would make the control scheme work on PS4, otherwise they wouldn't be bringing it, but you never know. I guess sometimes they make games and really don't really care about that. No! Gosh dang it. Interesting. So Elroda says most of the time he doesn't watch games, he just watches the streamer. But does the streamer have to be playing a game that you're interested in, like, from the get-go? Oh gosh. Give me experience points. Oh, I'm getting messed up. Jake, tell the rifle wolf. Transfer fuel is a big one. Okay. I'll wait for reviews to come out. Kerbal Space Program is not a game that I necessarily have been, like, itching to play, but I know a lot of people really enjoy it. Oh, looks like we got an interesting little Sveta here. I'm an exception because you don't like my personality. Oh gosh, let's go down. You don't like my personality, Mr. Elroda. You only watch because you know me. You feel obligated. Okay, fair enough. And Red Trooper, you said you've played KSP for a good deal of time. You've played it for a couple hundred hours or something? I'm bummed with myself about Crypt of the Necrodancer because I really try to pride myself on being, you know, decent at games like that and certainly good at roguelikes. Oh gosh, I can't even switch to Max. God dang it, because he's dead. No, this is like an easy Sveta hole, you son of a gun. I can't use this on Max. No, alright, so if I were to play this, Cole, I would hit it with medium speed and then put a mean backspin on it so it hits here, then backspins and rolls into it. Gosh, dang it, come on. I'm just trying to get a scoop. That's too much to ask for. I had a resurrection powder too, but I. Well, time to leave this dungeon. Oh, that's so frustrating. That's like an easy one. Like, so many of these, especially on this dungeon, could be so hard to do. Whereas that one is. I mean, that one you can mess up for sure, but it's relatively straightforward. Wait. Okay. I'm like, why do I have a key to a thing that I don't need to open? But Tetris burn. Ah, very funny. Exit the dungeon briefly so you can be alive. So this is like the city building element. So I've built all of these things. You go into this menu and then you download these geostones, these things that I'm finding in the map. It tells you the parts you can make. You make all these parts for certain kind of items you find in the dungeon. You place them in the area, you can paint them. Oh, I need 100 culture points? Appreciate it, I just haven't beaten the game. I got to the final boss, I got to the Necrodancer fight, but I lost, and it's like, ugh, God. I feel like I've played it so long and I haven't beaten it yet, whereas I feel more competent about those things. 100 culture points. Ooh, alright, let's build something that does culture. Let's, making a mailbox increase my culture points. Here, have a mailbox. Alright, I got 103 culture points now. No, no wooing. Oh my gosh. Anybody watch the Super Bowl? That guy being a CBS camera the whole time? Woo! Oh my God. How did he scream for the entirety of that game? It was like a 4-hour game. The wooer was wooing the whole time. Oh my God. Oh my freaking God. I was raging. Justine was even madder. She was pissed. She like wanted me to turn off the game. Yeah, but I it's okay. I understand it's what football fans do, Mr. Football fan, resident fan, Rad Trooper. But did they need to do it the entire game? And also, they're being picked up by CBS. Couldn't CBS, like the sound editors or sound mixers, do something to mute this freaking wooer? Yeah, I know you're losing your voice at the end of every Los Angeles Rams game. That's what you say, Achiever. The Los Angeles Rams. I need to buy some gun repair powder. Alright, Tetris back. I assume it's hard, but come on, can't do anything. Just mute the crowd audio. Like, do they not have the audio anywhere else? Ugh. Or just mute, use fake crowd audio. Do something. No care, just anything. Oh, you also have fish, and you can raise fish. Here, take a carrot. I gotta feed it one more time. Alright, I gotta feed stuff more. You can breed fish and use them for tournaments. The carrot, yeah, carrot is used for sex change. All my fish were male, and I want to breed some fish, so I changed one of them to a female. They've got different traits, and when you breed them, their traits are additive. They're not one for one. You put them together, and sometimes they go up, sometimes they go down. I'm just trying to beat this tournament where you race fish called the Finny Frenzy. Oh no, I've been eating carrots every day for lunch. Carrots change your gender. I mean, change your sex. Gender identity is not defined, but parts. Let's be clear here. Don't want to do anything in particular. No, let's go back to the dungeon. That's right. Man, I love some Jurassic Park. It was all last night, and I've seen this movie probably like 40, 50 times, and I still was like, maybe I should watch it again. This movie's really good. They really do. Jurassic Park 3 is an abomination. But even if that's on, I'll still watch that. Ugh. I need to own Lost World. Actually, I want to own all of them on Blu-ray. I own 1, 2, and 3 on DVD in a special box set, but I don't own Jurassic World yet. Yeah, the computer. Well, but the computer part is funny. It's funny enough. The you didn't say the magic word. Let's do some dungeon crawling. Ride pod so good. Yeah. Hold on to your butts. Oh. Hold on to your butts. Get killed. I almost have the master core for this thing. Oh, trust me, I never forget Sam Jackson in that movie. He's great. The hold on to your butts. That line alone is great. And then he says, I'm tired of this hacker stuff. Dang it. And then his arm, he turns into just an arm. He turns into just an arm. What happened to the rest of his body? Never know. Raptors got him. Spoilers for Jurassic Park, I suppose. Get wrecked, you mimic. Like my backflip there? My little backflip. I mean, with so many great characters like Nedry and Muldoon and Gennaro and Tim. No, Tim's not a great character, but Tim is a character. Tim's at least the like least annoying kid of all the four movies. Lex is pretty bad, though. Not gonna lie. No, I didn't miss. Anybody following those New Hampshire primaries? I know the results are just starting to come in, but I'm very curious about... Very curious about how those are gonna go. Wait, you didn't like the Kids of Jurassic World? I thought the Kids of Jurassic World were actually the second best. Let's not get started on the kid in Jurassic 3. Come on, he's so unbelievable. That's so unbelievable. Bernie's winning as well as Trump. Okay, thanks for the update, Alberta. Keep me posted if anything happens. I know they haven't, you know, a lot of districts still are reporting, but I'm curious. So many mimics. Oh my gosh. Did you see? Oh, I don't know if you watched the debate, guys and people in the chat, but oh man, Marco Rubio's like malfunction, his robot malfunction, where he's just repeating like the same line four times in a row, and then in a rally after that, he did the same thing again. No, not double coin. Tetris, this is a casual stream. We have fun. We talk here. People who are watching now, or people who are watching on YouTube. If you were here, joining the chat, you would know how easily we move from Jurassic Park to politics. Oh man, Rubio is so bad. Oh my god, Chris Christie embarrassed the hell out of him. Like, I don't like anyone on that side of the field. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I won't say my political affiliation, but I don't like anyone who's running for GOP. But man, oh man, that was like, he got embarrassed.
All right, that takes care of you guys.
Oh, that's true, the younger brother was from Insidious. That's one of the other movies he's from. Oh, got a medal. All right. Oh, gosh. Let's see, we wanna go up and then left and then down and then, all right, we can do this. Let's equip my putter first. No, too hard. Oh yes, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Thank the Lord. No, he wasn't just nervous. He was completely just like, he malfunctioned. He's a robot and he malfunctioned. No. Ah, gosh. All right, I had one extra hit, so. Of course, now I go too short. Gosh, dang it. This is not happening. All right, we're gonna have to try and do some crazy ricochet stuff here. Well, no. Nope. Gosh. I just don't know how you can take any of the people in the Republican field seriously. Like, none of them are serious. They're all robots and or they hate everyone who's not a fetus or a soldier. Or a white Christian male. Who came up with the exclamation mark? I don't know, man. Probably it's the Egyptians. They invented a lot of math, so could be them, because, you know, you have like factorials. Yeah, what does Rubio to do well on the fact he's not Trapper Cruz? That's true. He seems less sociopathic than the other two, which is, I'll take that. We're almost at the dungeon end, but let's go back to do some Giorama. The guide I'm following says take a break and do some Giorama, so I'll do just that. Rad Trooper, I gotta give you a teaser for the podcast we're recording Thursday morning. Your email to impactfactorpodcast@gmail.com inspired our perspectives. So, please be excited. Please be excited for that. Welcome to the Impact Factor. I talk like that the whole time. I gotta say, though, Elrota, Rad Trooper, they're solid. I mean, you guys are my great friends. You're my best friends. But also, solid fans of the Impact Factor podcast. Tetris, you don't leave no comments on the SoundCloud. I don't see no emails. What's happening, man? Are you caught up on the podcast? I'm calling you out on stream. Hardened mud pile. Oh, I'll take a picture of that. Oops. Gotta make another one. Hashtag damn shame Tetris. Hey, it's just what I do. It's what we do as big bros. Mud. Alright. So, you saw that little, had a little light bulb next to it? That means it's an idea. Come on, how is that not a picture of his head blowing up? How are none of these pictures of his head blowing up? So, Mud, you can move that to your idea book. Get saved in your list of ideas, and then you delete all useless photos, and you can see I've taken a lot of pictures. Tetris with these self-burns. I don't know how I feel about that. I'm supposed to burn you. Alright. Alright, we're in for a boss battle coming up soon here. So let's repair our ride pod, because the ride pod is ultimate boss destroyer. Repair him, good to go. Repair robot. Oh, actually, let's upgrade it. Let's get this trophy. Boom, trophy time. Trophy time. Wait, I want to see if I can invent the samurai arm. Hold on. Samurai arm. Or my dragon weapon war crane. No, I don't have war crane yet. Gosh dang it. Alright, right pod's good. He's good. He's good to go. Oh, let's feed our fish. Did anyone platinum Fallout 4? Good question. Yes, I know someone in the games industry, game space, who platinumed it. Greg Miller from Kinda Funny Games, recipient of the Game Awards, is trending gamer. Gotta say, the Impact Factor podcast won the Game Awards best new podcast of 2015. So just got a shameless plug there. Arf arf. Let's feed some fish. Have a Mimi. Have a petite fish. Have a Eevee. One more. Alright, I gotta feed him one more time. I'm actually very close to the platinum in Fallout 4. I could feasibly get it. The one trophy or achievement that's like stops everyone is to have 100% happiness in your settlement, which is like a ton of grinding. Cause I don't know if it's if it's working as intended, but like you need to make like 4 or 5 medical clinics and have a ton of shops and build like a bunch of rugs, and no one is even clear how to get it. And like if you leave your settlement, your happiness goes down, and it's just like a mess. So I got my happiness was at like 85%, but I didn't feel like to grind it. You have to spend so much money and so much resources, and you have to have really high charisma. Oh my gosh, Rad Trooper! I'm not even gonna dignify that with response. But like the only trophies I was missing was collect all the bobbleheads. I have like half of them, but not all of them. Get to level 50, which is just grinding, and then that I think that settlement one, to have your settlement have 100% happiness. I'm close, but I didn't platinum it. I don't think I will. Yeah, it's the Sims element. I didn't like the city building. I didn't even like do it. Mount Gundor. I did not even city build that much.
That's it.
Uh-oh, that's it.
So that's what's causing our fiery rain problem. Let's hurry up and destroy it.
All right.
Yeah, you need like a lot of stuff. It's more than that though, Rad Trooper. It's not just full employment in shops. You also have to have... Oh, Fire Squall. You also have to have like a ton of like medical clinics. So like the only way to get your happiness like really that high was having like 3 or 4 medical clinics and having like 20 people live in your settlement. It's ridiculous. Let's just make sure I have the scoop. All right, we got the Fire Squall. So this is a scoop, it's got a little star, which means it's like rare. Some of these scoops, like this one, are missable. If you don't take a photo of it, it will be gone forever. And you can't get it, and then you can't invent all items, which is a bummer. One more for the road. I'm paranoid about those kind of things. Oh, I got a time bomb. Time bomb. There we go.
Right. It's set. Get clear.
See, like looking at these cutscenes like this, you can tell where they didn't upscale. Like the character models have been upscaled a lot. They look pretty nice. But like some of these backgrounds and these cutscenes are not upscaled, and it's like it's so pixelated. It's crazy, because when I was playing as a kid, you know, it looked, you know, high resolution.
Yeah,
it looks so nice and so crisp and so smooth. But then when you look back at it now, it's like, oh my gosh, it's a separate point. But how did we watch TV in standard definition? How was that even possible? Every time I accidentally go to a standard definition channel on TV, I'm like, what the hell is happening? It looks so bad. Killed.
He's attacking!
It's no use. My magic won't reach at this distance. Max, use your ride pod.
Overkill for these two little kids. Blowing them up with a freaking blimp warship. Oh, if you guys haven't already, I posted a review for The Order 1886, and you, my good friends on Twitch, my good friends in real life, and my good friends on Twitch, might be particularly interested in that one, as it's a game I play entirely on stream.
Okay, let's do.
I'll link in the chat in a second. All right, it's boss to fight. Let's take a picture. Oh. All right. Get messed up. Even hitting anymore? Oh yeah, I'm doing damage. Get laser cannon! We got him. Oh no, what did you just leak in the chat? Oh my gosh, is this what I think it is?
Damn you, you little brats. Just how did you...
Gaspard, you won't slither away from me this time!
Damn, you're gonna get messed up by a grown leotard. Monica,
Monica!
No, Monica, how could this happen to me? You made a crater. Domestic abuse. Oh, El Rhoda, if you weren't such a good friend. I'm just kidding. How did you find this Baby Beluga song? Yeah, can I leave? Can I have a right pod? Is it an exit? I'll get you, Monica. I'll fire lasers down at you. Okay, where are we supposed to go? I don't remember this part. That's funny, I guess you could just loop around this entire loop. Oh, invisible wall? Gosh dang it, I think we gotta go all the way back around. I should film for a game trailer. Come on, look at that. Look at my filmic rotation of the camera. Well. I guess it's the arch. That's what I'm doing. That makes sense. Oops. All right, I have to go off the ride pod to go any further. Oh no, what happened to Monica? Oh, Monica. Hey, it's like 70 in Bay Area. It's never too cold for ice cream. Never too cold for ice cream. That's the way to the final boss, but I'm gonna... Something has changed in the future that I need to go see. No, Monica's gone. She's dead. Just kidding, she's not dead. Spoiler alert, she's not dead. Nor is Gaspard. This allows me to go into the future.
What's that? There's something there. I'll check it out.
This is for anyone who, a little fun factoid here, a little inside baseball. The voice actor who plays Max here, this character, is the same voice actor of Robin in Teen Titans, that Cartoon Network show. The more you know. So this is cool. Wait, is this a work crane? Does it work crane anywhere? Ah ha ha, work crane! Baby, work arm, work crane. Anyway, work crane. Worker. Not gonna invent a samurai arm. I don't know if that's his name, but Robin in the TV show, the cartoon Teen Titans, same voice actor who's this kid. It's like a robot arm, like a samurai arm.
What the hell?
How do I make a samurai arm again? I'm gonna look it up. Runaway dragon. Weapon and work crane. Alright. Yeah, it's these things you need a guide for, because like, oh, of course a samurai, a runaway dragon plus weapon plus work crane makes a samurai arm for the ride pod. Of course. But once you make something, you don't just make it. You have to build it with your parts. I need 5 silver balls. I want to make Sun and Moon armor, too. Probably make the Falcon as well. 6 silver balls. Ooh, need to make the Earn Energy Pack. How have I not been making the Earn Energy Pack? Wait, didn't I? Oh, no, I'm not even using the Earn Energy Pack. Ooh, I got a lot of crafting to do. Scott Mendel, he's bald. Yeah, it's funny. Like it's so funny when you're like, this shows you growing up. You're like, oh, that kid's voice is a kid. It's so iconic. But like, most of these kid voices are just adult ass adults. Oh. Ooh, treasure chest. Fruit of Eden. Yeah, finding these treasures scattered around here is a pain in the butt, because this place is so gigantic. So I'm in the future right now, I guess, in case anyone's wondering. I went to the future. And this is what I'm trying to repair. I'm trying to rebuild this workshop so I can make a giant flying weapon to help fight the evil Emperor Griffin. Yeah, Bart Simpson. Yeah, they're all like these old people. Though my favorite voice actor, Steve Bloom, he's the voice of Taskmaster in Marvel's Capcom 3. As well as
I'm Maximilian.
The voice of everyone and everything.
Maximilian? Could you possibly be Elena's?
You know my mother?
So you are then. You have your mother's eyes.
You have your mother's eyes.
That's nice to hear.
I'm Galen Nagaris. I'd been leading the rebels against Griffin, but it looks like
here's my order
of
you.
Has been erased
for
somehow.
Your viewing pleasure.
By the way, how's Monica?
Dead.
She was aboard Gaspard's battleship and fell into the Mount Gunder volcano.
I do like Tara Strong. I'm also partial. Oh gosh,
I'm heading
out
to save her.
There's a lot of great ones. Troy Baker.
Is that right? Then take this with you.
God, what's your face? Laura Bailey. Also, really like Laura Bailey. Voice actress. Ooh, Jennifer Hale's a good one, Red Ruber.
A dangerous place with a flowing river of lava. The going gets very rough. Use that when flames block your path.
Oh my gosh.
You should be able to make your way across the lava. That's.
Dun, 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 dun. Laura Bailey rocks. She's the voice of Valera. No.
It's one of my last. Red
Ruber, the voice
it
of the. Demon Hunter in Heroes of the Storm.
Thanks. I'll
What's
do
her name?
My best.
The twin crossbow lady. She's her voice.
Gaspard killed my friend.
I think she's probably also the voice of Valera. I shall be your death!
Raybrand was a noble king. But Gaspard defeated him.
King Raybrand?
That's right.
Vala!
Gaspard pay. Don't worry.
I know you can do it. The Atlamelia chose you. Good luck.
It's funny, when you take pictures of people, they always pose for you. Ventilation. Ventilation. Any other lights? Light. Gotta find ideas. Ooh, computer, that's a new idea. Pole, chair, computer. Oh, dang, he's a little busy. He's a little busy standing around doing nothing. Computer. Just making sure I get all scoops. Get all the ideas. Is floor something? No. Sometimes floors, there's things. Whoa! Oh, you'll play Hearthstone for a week. But get out of here! I thought you said you played Hearthstone this week, and I was all excited. I'm like, Aurora playing Hearthstone, PogChamp. PogChamp in the chat. That looks like a unique little light. Is this something? No, not anything. Yeah. The Atlamelia chose me for a reason. Sure did, that's my stone. Proudmore. Jaina Proudmore. I feel like on this one I missed so many of those tiny little chests that contain like items that are. Whatever, I'm not gonna run all the way here. This is gonna take forever. Time to go make some stuff. Sun and Moon armor, urn pack, samurai arm too. It's business time. That Pally's not gonna be OP in standard. At least, not currently. Though maybe, I don't know. It's still gonna have its Murloc deck mostly, which is pretty good. Yeah, mage isn't even that great. good. It's good for beginners, it's easy to understand, but a lot of classes are really powerful. Oh, I can't go back in time because I don't get the
blue
light, man.
Just at that moment, my Atlamine, the blue light that reached to the past.
Uh-oh. That's a convenient excuse how you can get back to the past. Hey, if I ever played WoW, I would have played Paladin. Oh my god, it's so bright. Ah! Alright, we're back. Uther was broken a long time in Heroes, because he's so powerful. He's like stuns and cleanses and all sorts of other stuff. Alright, repair my robot, you punk. Alright, let's buy some materials so we can make stuff. Why is no one on my train? Oh, I went in the wrong part of the train. Gosh, dang it. Where is everybody? Because I moved most people off the train. Alright, Kondo, let's... Oh, actually, I don't know what I need yet. I need 6 silver balls, though. Oh my god, that's so much money to make all these things. Alright. 5 sticky clay, 5 sturdy rock, 10 earth element. Oh gosh, I already forgot. Five sticky clay. I'll buy 6, so I don't run out. 5 earth element. Oh, oops. I need 4 more earth elements. 4 more earth elements. Let's make this. Make a falcon. I'll make a samurai arm, too. 4 earth element, 50 light element, light, holy, and sticky clay. Oh my gosh. Oh yeah, yeah. I never like using Uther in Heroes of the Storm. He has too much to do. It's way too many cooldowns to manage. All right, 29 sticky clay, oh my gosh. Four more earth element. Light, I need 50. Oh my gosh. I'll try and sell some stuff. Oh, I'm actually gonna have to buy more sticky clay. Gosh dang it. Nineteen sticky clay and twelve holy element. Oh, let's sell one thing so we have enough. Sell some of these. These are junk. These are like items you throw at enemies to kill them. It's so useless. Down to no money. But now we can make the infamous Sun and Moon armor, the best armor in the game for your ride pod. Elroda asked what are some other games that came out today. The big one was Firewatch, but let's see here. I only can speak to the PlayStation games because I'm a PlayStation-centric kind of person, main gaming platform. But let's see what we got here. We got ourselves some Firewatch, some Lovers in a Dangerous Space-Time in its way to PlayStation 4. It's like kind of a co-op twin stick shooter. I'm interested in. There's a new Naruto game. Believe it! Unravel. Unravel's a big one that came out today. Unravel, that kind of gem of the E3 EA press conference, came out today. Those are the big ones. I say those are the big ones. Sun and moon armor! Pot is ridiculous. The force we reckoned with. Spend all my money, but what else are you gonna use your money for? And the thing I invented was the Falcon, which is good for long shots. I don't know how useful it actually is, but I wanted to have all the Spada clubs. People. I recruited Pow. Why is he on the train? I'm gonna find you, Pow. Ooh, pork chops, potatoes, and mushrooms, Red Trooper dinner. What did you have for dinner, Elrota? Oh, it's a day late, but also, happy Lunar New Year, happy Chinese New Year, happy Tet, whatever you want to call it, to Elrota. And to everyone, I suppose. Pow, what, you're useless. Detection, detect mimics, detect gatekeep monsters. I don't need you. I need money. Cures, heals fully. We'll sell clothes for Monica. Let's buy some clothes for Monica. Striped dress. Wing boots. I gotta change her shoes, man. Alright, I'll buy her clothes eventually. Not now. Can't play fashion souls here. Whoa. Tenders for me had butter noodles, chicken fried chicken with some sauce and cheese, broccoli, half-grilled cheese, some fries, man. You sound like a college kid for sure, Tetris. You sound like my meals. I'd have like a sandwich, a burger, fries, a salad, cookies. Hey, man, when you got a dining plan, go all in. Back to the dungeon, I suppose. But Elrota, what did you have for dinner? You're asking everyone to have for dinner. I'm gonna have a burger for dinner. I'm gonna make it. Got some cayenne, cumin, salt, black pepper. Put it on a screaming hot cast iron pan. Gonna cook that up for when Justine gets home. Which is probably in about an hour. Yeah, he lost 10 pounds every break because he couldn't eat anything. Tetris, that's good though. Keep it up, man. Losing weight's, losing weight isn't always good, but losing weight's generally a good thing. We're almost done with Mount Gundor's dungeon. Let's save again because I'm paranoid. Defeat and tackle enemies using only the ride pod. That's right, man. Hopefully it wasn't all muscle. Yeah, that's true. Let's defeat everything with the ride pod. I'm in the game, everyone. Did you see me? That was me. Can I cook some rice, stuff with broccoli and anything, meatballs in it? Hey, sounds good, man. Get sliced and diced. This ride pod is a machine of death.
I shall be your death.
Ooh, he's headed for lunch at some pho. Oh! Wait, how much is pho? Man, you're going to the wrong pho place. Even in San Francisco, you get a... looks like you can get some good pho for like, $6.50. Oh man, I wanna get pho now. Mmm. I want pho. Pho is delicious. I should've had some pho for Tet. God dang it. That would've been a good excuse to go get pho. That. Get sliced and or diced.
Oh.
Whoa, $11 for a bowl of pho. Dan's game indeed. What the hell, man? That's too much money. Plus, it'd be cheap. Still, oh man, I know that feeling. That feeling of when you actually go out to buy lunch when you're at lab. Oh, it's so nice. Like, I bring lunch every day, but like, the random odd days where I don't bring my lunch, it's like so nice. I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna get a burrito. I'm gonna go crazy. Go, go, right pod ranges. Oh! Oops. Lots of loaded international Chinese students here. That's a target, I'm betting. Seriously loaded. We have a burrito place student union? Oh, man. You could be. I'm not saying you're wrong for being at Side Tetris, but San Francisco burritos are pretty good. I gotta say, you get some solid burritos. No. Let's collect the experience points as max.
All right, that takes care of you guys.
I don't want to move Max to the sphere, because if I move Max to the sphere, then I don't get the experience points. Hey, everyone can live in the Bay Area. Just gotta find a job that brings you out here. Because living out here without a job would be financial suicide. Let's see this guy. Oh, Sushirito. Yeah, we got Sushiritos here. I have never tried. Well, I haven't tried yet. One day, I will try the infamous Sushirito. No. Yeah, the only problem with Sushirito is it's downtown. It's down in the market district, the financial district. And I don't often go down to the financial district. Make it through the hole! Yeah, buddy! Aw, man, why is this a blue distortion? Look at that. Who's good at speed up? Me. That's great. Please be something good. Ooh, I'll take resurrection powder. That's good. I'll take it. Thank you. What item do I use for this? Oh, rope. Yeah, I'll report in once I have a Susurito. One day I'm just gonna leave work and I'm gonna go downtown to get a Susurito, eat that, and then come back to lab. Because it's also closed on the weekend, so I try to go on the weekend and it's closed, so. That's a lot of raw fish, though. I love raw fish, don't get me wrong, but it seems like a lot of raw fish to have in, like, one setting. Oh, I can't switch to Monica because she's gone. It's basically, you know how sushi uses, you have like the big long thing of sushi and they cut it up into pieces to serve the individual like sushis. But pretty much it's just like they give you the whole thing uncut, except they make it bigger too. They're giant sushi burritos. We'll go up. Looks like a dead end. I don't know why I'm so neurotic about clearing in dungeons. I'm like, I must clear everything. Oh, gosh dang it. Get killed. Alright, I'm gonna get max. So this is a kind of fun way to get experience points. So like, even though I killed it with the ride pod, like if the ride pod isn't there to collect experience, it goes to both your weapons. So that's like a nice way to level up your weapons. Pro tips. What are we on the launcher? Oh man, I started watching this show with Justine the other night. It's called, Married at First Sight. It's an Annie show. Oh, it is so good. I highly recommend it. It's crazy. The science of dating. They have these complete strangers who are getting married and they have 6 weeks to find out if they want to get divorced or try to make it work. They're matched on physical, religious, spiritual, emotional compatibilities. Oh, dang it. I meant to switch to Maximilian earlier, so he got experience points. It reminds me of this other show I've been watching from the Learning Channel, TLC, called Married by Mom and Dad, which is also great. Less great, though, because some of those people are really annoying. What up, Mimic? No, well. I assume this is the exit on these places. Oh, that's right. I gotta wait for him to, like, charge at me and then block. Falls over. Then pound him from behind. Wait, that did not come out right. Oh, repair powder. Alright, let's use a repair powder then on my arm. Let's not talk about pounding from behind. Oh, so that's a good thing about this game. In the first Dark Cloud game, if a weapon, the weapon durability marked by red here, if it went to zero, your weapon broke. And it was gone forever. So even though you've been building up like these weapons the whole game, come on. Even though you've like, been building up these weapons the whole game, you could seriously lose an item for good. Hours, dozens of hours of progress in weapon. Dark Cloud 2, they break and just makes them unusable. They would do no damage until you repair them. Thank God for that change. I never had a weapon break in Dark Cloud 1, but the fear of it breaking was, oh gosh. It was horrible, it was terrifying. Cause like, when you're in a dungeon too, like unless you buy the right items, you also can't escape. So it's like, and you also can't get out until you kill the monster with the key. And so if you haven't killed the monster with the key and your weapon is low and you don't have repair powder, oh my gosh. Thankfully, Dark Cloud 2, if an item breaks, you just have to go repair it or have another weapon handy. Oh, wow. Tetra says he had to soft reset on 1 and hadn't saved in like 3 hours. Yeah. Dark Cloud 1 is what he's talking about referring to with 1 there. Yeah, do the soft reset, i.e. turn off your game. Just turn off your console. Oh. Oh, man, come on. No, I want to shoot him with my gun. I want to blast him from behind. That also sounds bad. What's up, Bone Lord? Come on. That photo is also a scoop where he rises from the dead, but it seems like this game doesn't want to give me scoops. It wasn't a lack of powder either, so he's trying to level a staff guy. This monster took 4 durability per hit. Didn't notice it's too late. Oh, man. That's rough. Wait, who's the staff guy? I totally forget the staff guy. Blaster behind. That'll be my YouTube, that'll be the name of my YouTube video. Max blasts from behind Monica and Leotard. Man, I'm gonna get all the YouTube views. Seriously, I think I probably do need to choose better titles if I want anybody to watch my YouTube videos. Max blasting from behind. Volcano. Pounding and blasting from behind, a Dark Cloud 2 playthrough. exploding trap. Alright, weapon destroying trap. I always use exploding trap because the other two traps, the weapon stays there. Or the chest stays there. Whereas if it's an exploding trap and you get it wrong, the chest blows up and then you can no longer get its item. Now I need to buy more gun repair powder. Jeez Louise. You'll never guess what happens 40 minutes in. He goes from talking from politics to Jurassic Park. How did he do it? Watch and find out. Oh. All right, we got him. We zapped him. No, gosh dang it. It kind of locks you into your button, even though you're trying to attack with your other weapon. So Tetris, are you done with all finals? All right, switch back to Max. It is Hibbery Rad Trooper. It's a Bone Lord. No, gosh dang it. My hammer's too powerful. Oh, that's why you're referring to April. Hey, no, Tetris had to make up some finals. I know what I'm talking about, Rad. Ah, so repair powder for the enemy. Got one on Friday, need to schedule the last test. And final for the other.
That takes care of you.
Hopefully you get it done soon, man, because you're getting deep into the semester and it's like gonna be really hard for you to remember all that stuff. Alright, here's a sphere. Oh gosh, it's a long way to go to get into this distortion. At least I have 8 hits. Let's just use a swan. The game always auto aims you at in the direction of the gosh dang it, I didn't hit far enough. Hey-ya! Reduction of distortion. I'm not gonna risk it, I'm just gonna do a light hit here. Alright. Alright. Six hits. 6 hits remaining. Let's put a decent backspin on it. Oh no, no. Oh. Alright, that's good, that's good, that's good. Well, that's good, decent at least. Oh gosh. I might have hit it too hard. No! Oh, come on! Though, this gives me an idea. I might be able to just slam it in this room. No, no, no. Gosh dang it. Playing fast and loose. If I'd just gone the conservative route, I think it would have been okay, but now I don't think I'm gonna be able to get it. No, gosh dang it. Sweet. Alright, just power shot like crazy. Oh, like, of course that guy actually gets it there. Fast and Loose, another episode title. Doing highlight reels would require going back through and editing stuff. No, I should highlight stuff for Twitch. I never make timestamps. Mods, you guys want to make timestamps of interesting moments? I should, though. I should highlight. Here's some more highlights. As opposed to just, like, the entire playthrough. Let's move to the next floor! I have no clue. You probably would just have to, like, remember how long I've been streaming or go back through the past broadcast and find the times. I don't know. I don't know how Twitch modding even works. We're getting close to the final dungeon. Ooh, White Seal can't heal. Wow. Rad going in. Just like all JRPGs, nothing, there's no real skill. It's just understanding the systems and the mechanics and optimizing. Oh. Oh. I mean, I guess Sveda could be skillful, but that's, like, a lot of it is random. Like, I don't know if it's predetermined where the distortion in the ball is going to be. I got burnt. I freaking burnt. Hey, what's a bomber head? You gonna blow up? You gonna blow up? Oh god. Oh no, that is very dangerous to do here. I'm gonna get a game over if I'm not careful. Well, whatever. Screw these guys. Alright, so these little question marks restore your health, so that's good to know. It's good. It's good for you guys to know. I'm just getting messed up with this chat. Gosh. I'll play some Spelunky at some point then. I'm good at that game. Well, at least not bad at that game. And you can actually, and I actually have demonstrable skill. Take some nuclear throne again. It's been a while. I just want the game to be patched. The game has been kind of broken since launch, and it's been over 2 months now since it's been out, and not a single patch for the game. Ugh, it's unacceptable. It's annoying. Love that game. But I want to be able to use my alternate skins and be able to record daily challenge scores. Nuclear throne. I don't really need as much experience points for my ride pod anymore, so I might as well use it for weapons. Oh! Alright. No, not in Spelunky, a nuclear throne. Tetris, have you played Nuclear Throne, by the way? Spelunky's fine. Spelunky is totally functional at the moment. Alright, Spelunky's always been functional. I've never had any issues with Spelunky. Nuclear Throne is what I'm talking about. It hasn't been patched in over 2 months since it's been out. And from the beginning, it crashes if you die on the final area in the palace. It crashes if you die to the final boss. You cannot use alternate skins for your characters. You can't post daily or weekly challenge scores with any kind of regularity. You can, if you always forget the name, you can look at the title or in the where it says Megalodon PhD is playing, and you can see the name of the game. Oh man, I still got hit with the last hit. Gosh, dang it. Stay away from me. Alright, we're just gonna kill him. I don't wanna risk dying. Alright, most of what's enjoyable about your streams, not necessarily gameplay, is what I mean. What would a fan of generic JRPG game name like to see from someone else? Oh, yeah, no, it's not Dark Chronicle 2, Tetris. It's called Dark Chronicle for the UK. Oh, really? So, Crypto Necrodancer. Weird. I don't know when you stream anymore. Now I just come home, open up a tab, your Twitch, and... Hey, I keep a regular schedule. It's Tuesdays. I have it in my my description here. Tuesdays and Thursdays. 5:30 on Tuesdays and 6:30 on Thursdays. I've been keeping to it for the most part. Well, I appreciate it anyway, Patrick. I did, in fact, start streaming 20 minutes early today. I was trying to get more time in. I got home a little bit early because I was working on my lab meeting presentation for tomorrow. Ah, get shot. It's all right. Fair enough. I'll make your point. I do. It's hard to be regular. That's why I take Vaxalax. Lab meeting hype, oh, you know it. Hey, we have a good breakfast at least. Our boss is all about having good breakfasts. We'll have like meats and cheeses and nice bread and avocado and tomato and stuff. So it's not just like the cold bagels and cream cheese. White wind vase, what the heck is that? Oh yeah, man, I love me some avocados. Yeah, we get reimbursed. He makes us buy the stuff, but then you get reimbursed. We have like a $35 budget, which is like plenty for, it's plenty for buying that kind of nice food. Just gonna... No, okay, well, die then. Oh no, dress looked blue and black on TV. Why is White and Gold watching the same commercial on TV? Oh, it's happening again.
The sickening, it's happening.
What is the truth? What are the real colors? It was always black and blue. What is up? Yo, 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 what is up, Dark Emblem 3? Thanks for coming and hanging out. Fortunately, we're only streaming for another, like, 20 minutes or so, but thanks for being here. How's it going, man? You ever played Dark Cloud 2? On that there PlayStation 2? Nope. No. All right, let's switch to Ride Pod. I don't want to die. Get killed. Alright. That takes care of you guys. Alright. We did it. Oh gosh, dang it. Shouldn't have used the cheese. I should have just restored. That takes care of you guys. Gosh, where am I even supposed to hit this to make it like a nice shot? Down and then to the left and then down and... Oops. Don't do that. Misplays for days. Oh, it's probably too hard. Gosh dang it. Oh, nice. It's perfect. What misplays am I doing? I ain't even doing any misplays. Huh? Let's put a little meaty backspin on it. Alright, here we are. Oh, too far. Gosh dang it. That was a misplay. How much? I have 3 hits remaining? Yeah. Don't go in. Alright. No, come on! Well, we in this thing. Let's have it try worded aiming us. Okay. Oh, come on, God. Sveta, you jerk. Ugh. Next floor. Yeah, very curious, Dark Helmet, if you ever played Dark Cloud 2 or Dark Cloud. No. Sample of something not to bookmark. I can bookmark an epic fails. He's got two shots left to get the spade of ball into the distortion. You won't believe what happens next. All right, this will be our last dungeon, because then we gotta go make some burgers. Probably already pushing it. I'm doing it for you, the people. Have not played, hey, that could be your resolution. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. You should play them, they're really fun, man. Pounding that Alexander. Pound him! What's currently up on your playlist, Mr. Dark Emblem? Oh. Oh. How disappoint you disappoint me, Bone Baron. Oh. Need to buy more cheese once this dungeon is done. Gotta buy that more cheese. Yeah, no, she probably will be. That's why we're gonna do this dungeon fast, right? Right, boys and girls? It's not even Kappa. It's supposed to. Oh, all right, get shot. Man, the games are never ending, Dark Helmet, especially when you're like resolved to play all JRPGs that have ever been made. Gosh, I wonder if that's even possible. Just finished the Star Ocean series, but got the Xena series, Dragon Quest series, and Suikoden series. Well, if you played Suikoden 2 before me, let me know, Dark Emblem, because I have Suikoden 2 waiting for me on my Vita. I'm kind of afraid to start it. Or as we said back when we were kids, Suikoden 3. Hi-ya! All right, I got him. Oh, this guy's messing me up. Suikoden. Alright, some of these have probably gotta be mimics. Map, that's nice. Bone Lord. Oh, here's the White Wind Vase, it's nice. Oh, he thought you were gonna just jump on top of me, Mimic? Psych. I'm not messing with no King Mimic. Ugh. Come on, not Devil Side, dang it. I knew he was gonna have my health. Mother Lubber. Get shot. Back to max, get that experience points for my weapons. We're doing good here. Oh, good way, bat. Do some bread. There's so many mimics on this floor. Yeah, I see that weapon. Why? Okay, it's not even that bad. Honestly, you should probably just, like, never repair it until it breaks, but I'll repair it. I'll do it for you, Tetris. Four mimics. Let's use an antidote. Yeah, it's the concept. You don't like the feeling of a weapon breaking. I get it. Gosh dang it. Gotta go backtrack. Go all the way back. Back to where we started from. It's true. When things break, they usually disappear in games, Tetris. I'll give you that. I'm putting in the input for firing the gun, but if you're putting it, like, if you're on your trajectory to do the input for the melee weapon, it overrides the gun input. Final requirement gun. Really gotta buy more of that powder. Woo! I am lacking, that's true, I'm not lacking repair powder, but I am lacking, What's up, Alexander? Alright, so some of these are mimics. Said mimic. I need some Ripod fuel. That means at least one of these is a mimic. Cancel out of it with using a backflip. That means all three of these are mimics. Jeez. It's a mimic. Looks like we got them all.
Alright. That takes care of you guys.
Try Sveta, and then we'll be ending the stream. So hopefully we can go out on a nice note. I don't know though. This one looks challenging. Oh yeah, it only gives me 4 hits too. So that's probably too hard. Good. Well, could be better. Gotta be Cookie Mama. Alright, good. So here's a challenge here. I gotta hit it hard enough that it goes far enough, but then also put backspin on it. Yes! Alright, good. See, it bounced off the ground and turned blue, and then it cleared the distortion. We got it, boys and girls. Ooh, Sapphire. All right, thank you so much, everyone. Let's exit this dungeon. This is gonna be it for me tonight. I'll do my intro as I'm exiting. Thank you so much for watching. If you're watching here live on Twitch with me, thank you so much. Shoutouts to everyone who's in the chat, especially Tetris for me, El Rota, and Rad Trooper, who are here chatting with me as always, my good friends. If you're watching on YouTube, thank you so much for watching this first of this free plays. I'm trying something new, because I play so many games off stream, and I don't want to feel beholden to only playing them on stream, but I still want to share my experiences with you. So I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know. Give me any kind of comments, feedback of all kinds. And of course, everything I do, The Impact Factor, you can find on theimpactfactor.blogspot.com or on soundcloud.com/theimpactfactor, which is a podcast. Oops. Well, that was a waste. Have a good night, everyone. Thank you for being here. Oh, Dark Element 3. Of course, Dark Element 3. Here, too. Have a great night, everyone. Until next time, I'll be back Thursday by 6:30 p.m. We'll say that. It'll be by 6:30 p.m. Have a great night, everyone. Until next time, you know what to say.